Welcome back, guys. It seems a while. It's now June, so I'm putting April and May together for you to see. I didn't get out as much in May, unfortunately, due to reasons, and being lazy does kind of come into it. But first, I'd like to say, Paul Rennetts, well done. You won the prize, so that goes out to you. I'll be messaging you soon. And I really hope you guys enjoy the watch. Like, let me know what you think. Like, subscribe, please. Do it all. Right, enjoy, guys.
Right, guys, we're all set up. All three rods are out. I just bushwhacked them out. Bushwhacker, should I say. Little pop-up rigs. And this time I put some crumb and hob oilies in there. Hopefully it works. Didn't see nothing. Saw some pike, but that's about it. You just gotta keep confident during the times you're blanking. This place ain't easy. We had it easy on the first episode. That we did. Right, I'll update you later. I'm gonna get some kip.
Alright, guys, it's now 4 o'clock. It's about 12 degrees. Bit wind chill, but I'm in a t-shirt. It is nice. No liners whatsoever so far. I'm hoping we can pick one off in the next hour or two, but I don't know. Been 3 weeks without a fish on this lake, and then I've just heard someone else is coming down tonight on this lake on the other side, so thought you'd have to bring one rod in. But yeah, I'm now gonna go enjoy some cheese and onion twists and dip and a beer. Alright, I'll update you later, guys. Looks a bit like a sickly in that, but we've got beef casserole and dumplings. It would go down nice. Right. Man, the fishing is slow. But this is a hard place to fish. We made it look easy on the first one. Now we're regretting on the second one. Right, guys, the sun's setting beautifully now. I'm going to say night. I'm going to pack this away for tonight. And I'll update you in the morning. I'm pretty sure it's just going to be a dead. I've got the funny feeling me now it's going to be another blank. Third week without no fish. I hasn't done a fish since my last one. But I keep trying. And I'm pretty sure everyone else that fishes lake do keep trying. Alright, good night. Guys, it's now coming up for 9:30. Been awake since about 6 o'clock. No liners, nothing throughout the night. Yeah, it's just the same old here. I'm now reeling in for about 2-3 hours. Gonna go and do some work up the road, and then I'm back down here. All the gear will stay here, so I just got to flink rods back out. But right, I'll see you in a few hours. Right, guys, I'm back down. It's about 4 o'clock, so I'm going to quickly put the rods back out. Hopefully there's still a bite in the cards. It's longer than I actually thought it was going to be today. But yeah, no jumper. It's actually starting to feel a lot more like spring now. Green bits on the trees and everything. Just hopefully these fish, I know they're switched on, I just don't know if it's natural or what it is they're on, but yeah, it feels like I just need a bite now compared to what we had in the first vlog. We had it so good. It was a great start to a first vlog. Couldn't pitch it any better, really, especially with the big one at the end. Right, I'll update you later. Right, guys, that's it. Everything's on the barra. I'm now shooting. Nothing out. Someone's the other side this morning, so hopefully he catches. It just ain't done a bite since I had that 40. Can't moan. It's nice having it, but it's now 3 blanks in a row. And this one was a 48 hour, so that's even worse. But no work this week. And we're off fishing, obviously, as much as we can. Of course we are. We can do nights. Why not? So yeah, let's enjoy it. Hopefully we catch some. Morning guys, I'm down at my syndicate today. It's now Tuesday. We packed up yesterday. I had a little break at home. I'm back down the other syndicate today. We're just doing the point swim. Hopefully it pays off. Seen a few already, two show. I'm gonna try and pinpoint today. Today's gonna get to 14 degrees. Yesterday we had up to like 18, that was lovely. I think Ziggs would have been the one on here yesterday, but right, I'll just go get set up and then I'll update you guys. Alright, see you later. So right, we'll put two rods out now. We've still got to put the third one out. I'm just working out if I can see anything to go on, whether I put a Zig out or whether I put it down the tree line. But I've got two in deep water. Hopefully we pull one out of there. Right guys, enough to report. I moved the margin rod onto the staging. One on a Zig, one in deep water, just one off the island. I'll put the Zig rod on the deep water later. For now, just leave it at a Zig. But guys had a 25 pounder the other side. They were here this morning, so hopefully they come back or they're still here. Right, I'll update you later. Right guys, I haven't seen anything. It's now 5 o'clock. I've just reeled in my middle rod, which was my Zig rod. I've been moving it up and down in depths all day, but no joy. Well, tell I did have a roachie pecking at it. It must have been that. I reeled it in and it came to surface, but luckily it fell off. But I'm gonna stay here. I'm with the missus. We're basically just on a, she's just done 2 nights for me. We bought the whole works. We bought the T1 and the Extreme Canopy, which I'll show you now. It's humus. It's massive, should I say. Not abusive. But yeah. Right, I'm going to whip this rod out, guys. I'm just going to go and see my mates now. They're all just by the gate, waiting to come in. Hello, mate. Cows behind here in the field now. I think they're actually quite lovely creatures. Make good food too, mate. Right guys, that's pretty much it for today. It's 9 o'clock. I'm gonna jump in the bag and just relax. Watch, see if I can listen for any shows or anything, and then possibly I think I'll have a move tomorrow. Right, I'll update you in the morning, guys. See you later.
It's been a while since I updated you. It's now 12 o'clock, obviously the next day. We've moved, hence why the late update. And saw nothing or heard nothing during the night. Pretty much when I updated you, I had a cup of tea, then we went off to bed. As I said, where I am is the swamp, and that's where bike come yesterday. I didn't intend on moving because of that, but this morning I reeled in about 9 o'clock, walked around, and as I was walking around I saw two just lump out in the area that I'm in, so hopefully it brings a bite. I've seen nothing show since this morning, but let's be lucky, eh? Hopefully we get one.
And what I've done here, I've put one at the back margin, one towards this little green decking. Not well, I've come far away, about 6 foot off the green decking today. I think the bloke next yesterday was fishing diet. It was different weather yesterday, it's a bit more windy, not sunny. Obviously my other rod on the far margin was where the fish shoe this morning. It came out like 3 times, I think. I don't know if it's the same fish, but it looked identical. And then another one came out shortly after walking around. Then I made a decision to move. I was putting the rods out. Unfortunately, on a bare lead, a pike decided to try and nick my lead. So I played that for a bit, and luckily decided to not fight anymore and just let go of it, thank God. But middle rod's just halfway out here, a good spot I used to catch in the past. So hopefully we catch. It's been a bit dismal this month. I think April's been up and down, hot, cold, hot, cold, hot, cold. We just need the normal spring we get, really. We normally get a few big southwesterlies in it. I think we only had one. So, yeah, right. I'll update you later, guys. So, sorry, where you join me? Obviously, we're at our other syndicate. As you know, I might have said it yesterday. I don't know, I forgot. I haven't done too much recording. Obviously, Mrs. has been here as well. So we've had the T1, the canopy out. But today we've just got the T1 up. She's off to work later, so I'll be down here most probably by myself tonight. She'll pop down in the morning. Then we're off, and hopefully tomorrow we're off somewhere different. Somewhere I haven't been for a long time, and that's Hartsmere. Hopefully we can nab one there. It's just, I don't know if I'm doing anything wrong, or I personally think it's just this. Oh, I know this April's just been a funny one. This has done fish, this lake. Obviously, unlike my other syndicate, just haven't done any at all. It's just pain, really. Right, guys. Right, it's now 5 o'clock. I've seen zilch. I've had zilch. No one's had nothing on the other side there, but there's still time. We've got till tomorrow morning. I'm not overly confident. It's getting colder and colder now. We'll be off tomorrow for about 9:30, I reckon. We'll be gone because I'm off to Hartsmere tomorrow with Matt. Hopefully go and get him for about 12. Bloody wind causing my line to obviously cause my alarm to go off. False lines, as they say. But yeah. Right, I think I'm gonna put the kettle on. If anything interesting happens, I'll let you know. Alright, just watching the water now, see if I can see any last minute shows to possibly move. I'll stay near to fully dark. And then from dark I'll just keep an eye out for any big splashes that I can hear. Try and work them out where they are, and if so, I will move. I don't know what time to stay up to. My guess is about 11 o'clock at night. But if I don't update you, it's because nothing's happened. And I will update you in the morning. I won't get this out too late. There's no point of recording during the darkness. But it's not fun. Just keep blanking, blanking and blanking. Fair enough, at the other syndicate, we're fishing somewhere a lot harder than this as such, but I don't know. I felt like we've been on them, but we just haven't been lucky. Right. I'll update you in the morning. Hopefully we update you before then. Well, nothing for me that session. I did move late at night, around about 9:30, 10 o'clock. Moved it back into where I started. They started showing there, so I moved there, but unfortunately no joy. I did pack up early. As you'll see, I met up with Matt for some fishing. So yeah. Alright guys, we're down at Waveney Valley Lakes, as we said was going. We didn't go Hartsmere, we got offered to go on marsh. And Matt said he's never caught a cat before, which made me want to help him catch a cat. His first one, so hopefully we do. We're just set up, rods are out, we're all ready for a fish. We're now going to put the barbie on. So yeah, happy days. Right, update you later. There you go, the first one. A catfish. I don't know whether to hold this or not. What do you reckon, Matt? Shall I hold it?
Hold it, mate.
Hold it, yeah. We're going to hold it, right.
A nice catfish to start the session off. This is the first one Matt's in on the bank, I believe. So that's a good start. It's almost, I reckon, just over 3 foot in length. We'll just give him away and then we're going to slip him back. I'm not going to hold him up. We just weighed him. 26 pounds is a small and foot light. But we didn't have a catfish or a carp to begin with, but you did fight like a catfish. I'm letting him go. He just want to go back. I won't hold him thrashing around too much.
All right, we're off the mark. Hopefully Matt catches one now.
Whee!
That'll be his first catfish, so if I catch another one off that rod, I'm calling him and he's going to play it this time. And he's going to hold it. Right, brilliant. I'll update you in a bit, guys.
Would you like a bite? Let's have a chew on it.
So Jason's into something by accident.
Literally, we put the rod on the spot and it's just pretty much went out of the hand, the rod did. I think I might have possibly foul hooked it. Unfortunately, all we're going to have to do is just play it in, unhook it, and hopefully let it go again. I've been told this is full of cats, I think. That's quite possibly true. Twice on that spot, I felt fish on the way down. And this proves that they like that deeper water this time, especially in cleaner, I guess they like the cleaner areas than the hard, soft areas, but I'm going to put one on the soft area for tonight. And try, see if they do like a bit of silt, but for some reason they always like the hard spots in here. I found out last time I come here. And Matt is playing the next one, aren't you, Matt?
As long as it's not foul hooked.
Don't promote bad angling, but I've got nothing to do but play it in. And you can tell by this how much it's hard enough playing in when they're hooked in the mouth, let alone put any other way.
Taking you, mate.
Sure, they're right, kicking, aren't
they? Well, the last one was 26. I'd hate to think what this one is, Howard. 10 pounds.
All right, I'm going to start applying some pressure. See if I can get it to turn. Once you can get him to turn, you let him on a little run. No fights like catfish. Especially on this lighter carp gear, they're just so fun. That would be a yearly fix of catfishing. Does. I prefer carp, always will. But it's nothing like herking a moggy, is it? Oh, there's a carp. Nice and tight to the bank. Showing the size. Seems like there's a few smaller ones. We're seeing a few, aren't we, Matt?
Mm-hmm.
Smaller ones today in here. Oh, and again. I should have put this rod on it, really. He told me they don't go close in, but I think that proved otherwise then. I didn't really see. Did you see if it's big, Matt? Or...
No, I was trying to look at the camera. So it just kept hearing the splash.
You're not like me, daydream. I'm more interested in the carp, but... Go fishing, go catfishing, they said, it'll be fun. At least we caught something today, I suppose.
Yeah.
Other than that, we've caught something and we've managed to get ourselves in a spot of trouble.
Sorting my rod out a maze away.
Or is it?
Oh,
yeah, it's definitely
a cat. I know, is it? I'll grab your net, mate. Watch your foot. It's something. Oh no, it's a carp. It's a carp.
Yeah.
That's what we
got. A cat and a carp. Cool. In the
there we go. Oh,
you got it?
Yeah, that's in.
Lovely job.
Well
mate.
Done, mate.
Happy days. We both caught.
Yeah. But we caught that one on the drop. Funny enough, we actually caught it in the mouth. We thought it was foul hooked. Right, this is the this is 48 pound, this one. We caught it on the drop. I'm not going to lift it up. It's very slippery. We're on an uneven bank, so it's unsafe. I'm going to do the right thing and just hold it like this. You can see it. Matt will show you what it's like at the front. And I'll lift the front in for you. Look at that big mouth. It's all eyes and that. Amazing creatures. Right, I'm going to get this one back. This one's really lively. It's ready to go back. He's ready to go back to his home. Right. See you later. And that's why you hear the big splash right by that big tail.
Now Matt's capture. Yep. Here's Matt. What so you got, Sam?
So I've just literally just slung a rod out about an hour ago into the bay, just to my left, which is to your right. And my rod's just gone bolting off just after Jason just landed a 48 moggy. So proper chuff with that. He's a bit feisty, so I reckon I'll weigh him up, sling a bit of water on him, get him straight back in, I reckon. So happy days, hopefully more to come tonight.
Well done, Matt.
Nice one.
It's nice to just be catching, isn't it, mate?
It is indeed.
Nice to have a bit of fun. Right.
Happy days.
Right, guys, the day's now coming to a close. It's now getting dark. Obviously, with them two cats, last cat I got on the drop, I thought I foul hooked it, but I actually didn't. Got ducks chased foul. Bloody things. But yeah, Matt's had his carp, which he's enjoying a cup of tea, chilling now. Hopefully get another bite during the night, it'll be nice. If not, first morning would be lovely. Let us sleep and that. But yeah, if I don't report back to you tonight, I'll definitely update you in the morning. All right, see you in a bit.
I reckon you'll be right.
Matt's into a cat. Well, not long ago I had a 20 pound. We didn't record it, but we just slipped it back. But Matt's now in and it's absolutely ripping off. And it's even better, it's the rod he just redone not long ago. It's absolutely scrapping him about, so I'll give him a hand now. Then we'll show you when it's on the bank. Here's Matt with his 47 pound cat, his first ever cat. So yeah, it's nice to see. Right, I'm gonna take some photos for him now. Right. 47 pound, look like that. Are you happy, Matt, for your first?
Very happy, mate.
Fish. Well done, mate.
It's always we'll a skull, it's just a bloody big ear, wasn't it?
We'll slip it back now. Morning, guys. We're both awake. As you can see, I ended up reeling in my rods. It was a savage with cats. I think I finished off with two more, so I think that puts me on five, unless I didn't update you about the other one. And Matt had a 51. And a 47, I believe, didn't you? Yeah. Nice, but we're going to give it a little while, as you say. We're going to keep one rod out. It's where the carp spot really is on here. But give it some time. Cook some breakfast. Cook some sausages, some bacon. And yeah. And I reckon we'll have a gentle pack up. Right, guys, we're now off. Everything's packed away. I think me and Matt are both happy we both caught, aren't we, Matt?
We are absolutely chuffed.
So, we both had a cat. We needed a carp, which we should have been really fishing for, but they just really weren't having it, so thought we'd have a go for the cats. Right, thank you, Blakey at Waverley Valley Lake, sorting us out. And roll on this weekend. Hopefully we catch one of the ones from the syndicate. So, yeah, right, see you later. Right, guys, it is now the 2nd of May. I didn't make it down last weekend, so I'm adding this bit into last month's vlog, so technically we're in May, so we'll lose a bit of this episode, but pretty sure this will be a short one. I got here last night, had a quick barbecue, and pretty much hit the bed. Such a long week. I did come down last week, I walked around, just didn't vlog it. It was just dead last week and I just didn't feel it, so I pretty much went to go and see some other mates fishing. And yeah, just had a weekend chilling. I don't feel confident this weekend. It's most probably going to be my last weekend on this lake. This is the syndicate we caught the 40 on, so time's short, but hopefully we squeeze a session in next week. But if we don't, we had a good year on here. Well, for the vlog last month, we caught, four. So, can't moan at that. All right, rods have been out. Didn't see anything. Actually, I did see one. But no liners throughout the night. I felt quite confident after seeing that one show, but nothing. Very cold this morning, very. It was like, as you can see by my breath underneath the brolly, it's like minus one, I think. For May time, that's just weird, right? Update you later.
showing with the £32 fully. Well done. 34?
32.4.
Oh, 32.4, okay. Well done, mate. It looks...
Cheers, buddy.
It's absolute mental fish, this one. Well deserved. Go on, Shane. That is absolute mega carp. That seems a long time since I've seen it on the bank. It's mega. Come have a look at them scales. Look at the gut on that thing. Whee! God!
Oh, you have got leaky pear.
Well done, shitters.
Yeah, well done, mate.
That is absolute mega. Absolute mega, mate. Well done, mate.
Well done, mate.
Absolute beast, that is. Absolute beast. One last hold.
Let's get back now, mate.
Well done, mate.
Thank you very much.
Mwah.
Look at that. See you next winter. There she goes.
Well, that's a nice fish. Absolute mental, that filly. I've had it, I think it was my third fish ever out of here. But I plonked two rods out, I let him go in the wind, I knew it was going to do a fish, I just knew it. Switching to a southwesterly, this warm, I think every fish in the pond will have followed it first, but I think they're spooked off now, and I think this is where my chance will come in. But I've got two rods out, where I normally put them on the first episode, and hopefully it brings some luck. Right, I'm now going to collect my grub and we're going to go and have a quick barbie. So, I'll update you later. So yeah, it's been a bit of a tough one on there. Unfortunately, nothing for me as you see Shane catch one. It's a real nice fish, that one. Really special. Unfortunately, that's the end of that for this season. I've got to wait till August till I can fish that lake again. I will be returning. I do want the big one out. So hopefully I do get it this year. It would be nice if it would top my year.
Morning, guys. It's now coming past 8 o'clock. Just whipping up some breakfast. Haven't seen anything, got here late last night. Well, I say late, about 7:30. But yeah, hopefully it's enjoy. Right, I'll update you later.
Right, we got one in the net. Now I can get it out, it looks like a chunky common. Yeah, so we'll go and have a look.
Yeah.
Ain't that good, Bruce? Cheers, thank you.
Haven't weighed it yet. One of the lake's big commons. Absolutely happy to be off the mark on this lake this year. It come a long time of blanking, but it all came true. Right, I'm going to slip it back. Now in. Boom.
Maybe 36, 35,
35, 12,
I reckon.
35, 12, yeah?
Yep.
Right, nice. I'm sorry, that's been rested. I'm gonna let it go now. Lively.
Right, sorry if you get a lot of background noise, but it is what it is. We're right near a road. We had that bite about 9:30. Haven't had nothing since. It's now 5 o'clock. Kind of just enjoyed the day so far, not recording that because we caught one. I haven't seen anything else show. No more liners. We actually got ripped off that, down on that rod before we went off, but didn't dink the hood. Must have still been presented. We got away lucky, but yeah. Got a nice one in the bag for this episode already. Right, I'm now going to enjoy my tea. Got chicken and waffles. Right, I'll update you either in the morning or later. Right, bye. Right, that's the rods redone for the night. I'm going to call it a night. I'm going to come off cam now. I'll update you in the morning. But yeah, I come on to braid. You might see it on the rods now for this lake. The other syndicate that I caught the 40 from is closed. We're off the mark of 35, 12, mint common. So yeah, right, I'll update you in the morning. Right, we had a lovely wake up call this morning from a mate. We popped over there, went to go and see him, done some photos. Yeah, about 4:30, so it's a nice early reel in for me. Check the rods back out, it's now coming up for 9 o'clock, so I reckon I'll give it about 30 minutes, maybe an hour, and then I'm off. I'm gonna try and get down again this week, so yeah. Hopefully we have another bit of success, but nonetheless we caught one. Which is better than last month. It's a bit hard, but now we've got hotter nights and that. It's looking better on paper. Alright guys, I'll catch you later. Down here with Guy and Pierce. That can only mean one thing.
Daisy, out way.
Thermal!
Thank you very much.
What you got to say on the matter?
Lovely carp, mate, lovely carp.
Then I soon went, not long after, went home, redone my gear, had a night at home, and then I headed back down the lake the next afternoon. Right, you join me back down the syndicate, the other one, where I caught the 35 from, common. I got down yesterday afternoon, about 5 o'clock. I didn't really walk around as such. I saw enough here to kind of make me warrant to go in here. A lot of rain when I got here. It was dreadful. I thought, you know what, I'm not going to vlog tonight. I'm just going to put the rods out, kick back, and then I'll start tomorrow morning. And yeah, when I woke up, Ed had one, which I'll show you now. He's Ed with this nice 20 pounder. Great start to the day, Ed. What a fish, nice one.
Days.
Well done, mate.
Here's the Winklinator.
Check out this mint 20 pound common for Yaxley.
Cheers, mate.
Happy days.
So yeah, that was a nice looking mirror, that one. £20, I think it was £20 or something. Well done, Ed. I also had one shortly after. I pretty much went towards the swim, had the take. So I got, because we're not that far apart, I walked literally not even halfway. I just literally just left the rods and yeah, I just beep 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 beep. And yeah,
didn't take long to play in. It was £20, 12 ounce common. Seemed to be quite a good thing on here. Well, thing for us, should I say. Two commons in a row. When there's more mirrors in here, it's quite funny that. But yeah, not so much this morning. It's all one show to my left, but we had the fish off the right, not far where I had the common, just in the slightly in the margin, just bushwhacked it in again, little pop up. Good little pop up rig again. Some crumbed up Scopex. I put about 5 or 6 whole boilers in there this time, not a lot at all. I just don't think they have it. I think mouthfuls are the one at the minute. I think that give them something to feed at, and the, hopefully the crumbs stay in that silt or gravel. I think it's just silt out there. It's a bit harder silt, but it'll just linger there, that crumb. It works well for you. Right, anyway, I'm going to kick back, relax. Got loads of stuff to tidy up. Bivvy's an absolute mess, should I say, probably. Right, I'll update it later. Right, it's done nothing but rain. Managed to squeeze a bit of breakfast in here. Had a nice steak from leftover from the other week. I think it was last week in Dale. So I had that today. Absolutely lovely for breakfast. But seen a few in the area earlier. Since it's got later on in the day, or should I say later on in the morning, I ain't seen nothing. Possibly one or two still about. Hopefully we'll see something. No lines whatsoever, just absolute rain. Rain, rain, all rain. Right, I guess I'll update you later. Now coming up for 2:30. No action as such. Just glad to see the rain stop, really. Right, guys, good morning. It is the next day. I got here, I reckon, about... Well, I set up in here about 5 or 6. I did plan coming here the other day. Ed was in here. Wait for him to go and thought, you know what? After what we saw the other night, there was nice shows. Maybe we want to come here, but it's started blowing a good wind in here. Someone's gone back in gatekeeper, so can't really get back in there right now. Looks good. Looks good for the day, but looks really good up here for the night. Tonight. So, can reel in a minute. Go and have a wash and that. Change your clothes. And then I reckon I'll be back up here. Yeah, it's just nice to be out. Right, I'll update you later. Well, it's happened. Rod absolutely screamed off. And it looks a good one as well. Looks chunky, right. Everything Wyatt sort out some pictures.
Yeah, that's better.
Here we go, the dink. Happy days, right? Put some Medicare on it and then I'm slipping it back.
Yes!
Yes! Yeah, so that's not so bad.
They're underexposed. Change it for the next side. Keep it there, isn't it? Okay.
26 pounder, straight after the other one. What session it turned out to be so far. Right, I'm going to slip it back.
Thank you, fish.
Right, I was very lucky. We had them two fish. Pretty much had a recast. About 20 minutes later, boom, boom, boom. We had to. 29, caught the dink, and a 26. I believe I caught that last year at 23, so it's nice to be having bites. I knew they were going to follow this southwesterly. It blew like southwesterly for like 2 hours, and it just came alive. It's now more south-southwesterly, but tomorrow I'm going to get true southwesterly, so yeah, fingers round. All the sound, we get another bite. Right, I'll update you later. Right, that was it for that session. I stopped recording. I had a good social with my mates the next day. I had them two fish. It soon got dark. It all went a bit quiet. Unfortunately, we didn't have anything in the social teller. Ian did, but he don't like being video recorded, so we let him off and had a good social. Barbecue, beers, really enjoyed it. Right, hi guys, that's the end of this episode now. Thank you for watching. Unfortunately, spawning has taken place. I know we've had a real mild spring, really, really mild spring. It wasn't the best spring ever, but it is what it is. We've got to let them rest, do the right thing. Hopefully we get a bit of June in there to put on there, on episodes, so you can watch it. Because at this rate, it's going to be cut short. But yeah. Thank you for watching, really, really thank you. And thank you for all those who has subscribed to my channel. I really do appreciate it. But we'll be back soon with another episode. Right, thanks again. Thanks for watching.
Lovely one.